So Apple released iOS 13 to the public last week, and if you are anything like me, you're probably extremely curious on how the upcoming version is going to change your iPhone. And really, that curiosity is going to be well justified because that iPhone is your constant companion, and you really use it to manage everything in your life. Well, you're in the right place because I've been using iOS 13 as my daily driver, and in today's video, I'm going to outline the iOS 13 features that are going to supercharge your iPhone. I am Mike, and this is Tech 24/7 TV. Thumbs if you like this type of content, sub if you want to see more iPhone and iPad related videos, and now let's get started. Apple showcased a boatload of new features during last month's WWDC with the intent of galvanizing the iPhone as one of, if not the most critical element in your life. Now that's because for most people, myself included, probably even you, that is because their iPhone is gonna be by their side from the moment that they wake up to the time that they go to bed. I mean, there is a really good chance that you're watching this video while being in the bathroom. Hey, no judgment, hashtag infinite loo, hashtag Apple pun. Now, beta testing is really not for the faint of heart, and if you are thinking about taking the plunge into the beta, make sure that you have a local backup of your device prior to performing the upgrade. Now, I have a full review coming for iOS 13, so if you are interested in that type of content, make sure that you're subscribed with notifications so that you can be alerted when it drops in the fall. Apple's putting the pedal to the metal in iOS 13 and introducing several great features into Safari. Now, first, if you are someone like me, and you probably have all 500 Safari tabs open, and you use Safari as a notepad of sorts, you can now configure Safari to auto-close those tabs based on the length of time that they've been open. Second, similar to Safari on the Mac, you can now establish default and one-off preferences for websites that need to access your location, your microphone, or even the camera. That's right, you can stop that constant annoying pop-up from Google asking to use your location every time you want to perform a search. It is such a pain. You can find the default preferences in Settings under Safari, and the one-off settings are located in the address bar. And even better yet, if you're using a pop-up blocker like I am, iOS 13 streamlines disabling it with one click because it's now going to be in that same menu bar. New in iOS 13 is the ability to stream audio from your iPhone to multiple pairs of AirPods, regardless if those other AirPods are going to be paired with your iPhone. Now, most of us has really wanted to share audio from our phone with a friend or loved one before, but that has been almost impossible unless you're gonna share one of your earbuds with me, or one of us is carrying around a headphone splitter and wired headphones, but really, who's got time for that? And I am not about to put your earbud in my ear, and I am certainly not letting you put my AirPods in your ear because that's just gross. No offense. Well, Apple has us covered in iOS 13, providing that you already own your own pair of AirPods or Power Beats, because it's 100% easier for two people to share an audio stream, listen to a movie from a single device. Now, to enable this feature, your AirPods need to be in your ears. You're gonna go ahead and navigate over to Settings and go to Bluetooth, pop the top on the other pair of AirPods, and then hit the pairing button. Now, within a moment or two, those second pair of AirPods are gonna appear in the section at the bottom that says Other Devices. Now, there is another way to go ahead and pair your AirPods that uses proximity between two devices. I have not been able to get that to work for me during the betas. If you have, let me know in the comments below. Now, it's all about the details, and in iOS 13, it's gonna smooth out the rough edges that really have been existing for a long period of time. Now, it's whether it's the animations while you're scrolling through the Animojis and Memojis in Messages, or it's the redefined volume display that no longer takes up the home screen like an unwelcome relative. There are a lot of improvements in UI and usability coming to iOS 13, but my absolute favorite update coming to the UI is gonna be that all devices running iOS 13 now get contextual menus, including the iPad and even the iPhone XR. Now, that means that you'll be able to set your Wi-Fi network preference or even your Bluetooth accessory right from Control Center, or see the suggested actions just by pushing on the app. Now, this was previously limited to devices that supported 3D Touch, but now it's being expanded outside of that to any device that runs iOS 13. Siri gets better with every software release, and this year doesn't disappoint. That is unless you're using Google Assistant, but that is a topic for another video. Siri is more deeply integrated into iOS than ever before. First, there's things like Siri Suggestions, where it will go ahead and suggest websites to you that is found inside of your Messages app or presumably other messaging apps. Second, Siri Suggestions will remind you while you're texting someone that has a reminder associated to their name. But my absolute favorite Siri enhancement in iOS 13 is really gonna be announced messages with Siri. Siri can whisper your incoming messages as they arrive without the need for you to go ahead and prompt her. Now, if you are anything like me, you probably have a dozen or so message threads that you don't want Siri to read. No, it's not because of that. It's things that they're like two-factor authentication messages, it's receipts from people who aren't even your contacts, and I don't need to have Siri read them to me. That problem is easily solved because you can tell Siri that you only want certain messages read from ones like from your people that are your favorites, people that are in your contacts, or even recent message threads. And if you're someone who only wants this feature enabled part of the time, it's great, you can go to the control center and there is a toggle to enable, disable it very quickly. Now, I don't want to speak for you, but I'm eagerly waiting the day for when my phone is self-aware and it can perform tasks without the need for some type of prompt or input from me. Now, we got a small taste of that future when Apple acquired the popular Shortcuts app in 2016, maybe 2017, and then making it a first-party app in 2018. Well, this year, Shortcuts is fully integrated into the operating system, and it's a default app in iOS 13. Now, I can't blame you if you didn't take the plunge last year because the process of writing an automation was kind of daunting, and really, I'm calling it a process, so that should kind of say that how daunting it was. This year, writing a shortcut is largely simplified. Now, you might be thinking to yourself, hey, what does this even mean? How can I even use this? Well, if you've ever connected your phone to a Bluetooth speaker in your car, iOS will autoplay the very first song in your library, which is completely annoying. I wrote a shortcut that says, every time I connect my phone to CarPlay, it's gonna open a specific app. Now, that app could be Overcast, it could be DIFM, it could be BBC Radio. You can actually write it to be any app that you want to. Frustration is solved, and we are one step closer to Cyberdyne systems. But seriously, if you are interested in learning how iPhone automation can simplify your life, make sure you're subscribed because that video is me coming in the future. It's all about removing the small annoyances and distractions that really build up over time. And for me, iOS 13 is taking care of many of those nuisances. But I would love to hear from you whether or not you've already upgraded to the public beta or if you're waiting out to the fall. I want to know what your favorite feature is in the comments below. Hit like, hit subscribe. I am Mike Caputo, and this is Tech 24/7 TV. I will talk to you in the next one.